its lieutenant parents. What emerges from this disturbing matter is the picture of a man with no respect for the post he swore to uphold, a lieutenant who brazenly abused his position of trust and authority. Again, all three men are being arraigned at this hour. Prosecutors are now urging that they be held here without bail. If they are convicted, the sentences are steep, up to 60 years in prison for Peralta and life in prison for Martinez and Perez. Live in downtown Brooklyn, Jay Burke at Channel 7. Eyewitness News.
NJ, thank you. A teenager within the last hour charged with bringing a loaded gun to his high school in Brooklyn. That happened today at Utrecht High School in the Benton intersection. Police say a fight video posted on social media this week shows 17-year-old Daniel Marl with a gun. That prompted a teacher to confront the barrel in class today. The teenager allegedly admitted to having it. He's now charged with criminal possession.
Police in England are no
longer providing information to the U.S. about the Manchester terror attack amid rising tensions between British officials and the U.S. Comes after the New York Times published pictures of the device used in the suicide bombing on Monday that killed 22 people outside an Ariana Grande concert. British intelligence are angry that the pictures were leaked and they are blaming American intelligence. The bomber's father and two brothers are now in police custody as a massive search continues for others who may have been involved in the attack. Meanwhile, Madison Square Garden is having its first concert since the Manchester attack will be in timely time. I would assume reporter Jim Dolan is at the Garden tonight with former Jim.
Security at the Billy Joel concert, to be sure, but also just a change in focus, a change in tactics. Police will still be keeping a close eye on the people.